All right, so I know Sentry's a PvP character, so what am I doing? Well, basically, Sentry has effectively become the most expensive character in the game to tier 4, and because of that, as usual, I gotta test his utility. So, gotta put him to the ringer, see how he performs in PvE, and then after that, I'm gonna toss him into PvP, because that's primarily his place, right? He's always been a PvP god. And obviously this time around is going to be no different. So just a quick explanation as to why you're seeing me use Sentry in whoa, this man just got guard broken. How the hell did that happen? Got guard broken and knocked back so far too. That's rare. Go ahead and see if we can wanted to see if we can dodge that Clintar cage. Nope, no dice. Okay, where's my proc, bro? Here we go. Jeez. And by the way, I'm using him with a CDP of Rage. So the damage you're seeing here could definitely be, I would say, 20 to maybe 30% better, maybe, depending. At least 10 to 20% better for sure. Reason why I'm using him with a Rage is because, one second. I wanted to use him in Giant Boss Raid as well, and Rage is better there. But if you wanted to use him with energy, just use the 4 first, let him slam down, then use the 5, then use the 3 right after. So cancel the 5 right away, cancel the 3 right away, proc on the 6, that's going to give you the most damage. And then the 2-in-1, you're just tossing in to build up your tier 3 as quickly as possible. And then when your 6 is not ready, you're procing on 3, okay? Go ahead and run away. Damage-wise, with a CTP of Rage, I would say he's a little bit weaker than Beta Ray build, but Beta Ray build primarily I would be using with a CTP of Judgment, and obviously the Judgment is superior to the Rage for PvE content. Well, not all content, specifically World Boss content, I should say. Don't want to get it misconstrued. Also, when you're going to use your 6, you want to also make sure you use your third skill right away. To be honest, you should be using all of your skills right before your 6, so that you have as many skills hidden as possible, so you can do as much damage as possible. But the 6 hits the hardest when the 3 is up, because the third has the accumulation. So you want, hold up. Okay, thought I was gonna get taken over by the symbiotes. Symbiotic takeover. I'm probably gonna get hit and die and lose one of my lives. Nah, we Gucci. Okay, hold on. I'm stuck in my ways. I was stuck in my third skill, so I had to tag out there right quick. But it's all good, because it's gonna work out to be about the same time if I just dodge the attack anyway. So couldn't skip the dragon phase. This is level 70, keep that in mind. Just wanted to take a brief look at the boy at 70, and then obviously we're gonna build him up to 80 and then see how he cooks. Now hurry up. Okay, can we cook him before he, there we go. Now do we kill or do we die if we try to press him right here? Let's see. Press him. We don't die. Enough damage reduction on deck, but we don't kill. Not enough damage. Okay. You know what would be cool? If that little cutscene actually changes based on what uniform you have on your account for a Thor. Simple shit like that would make the game a little cooler. This is me. That's just me. So yeah, almost 4 minutes. Not the greatest, but at least he can do it at 70, so that's something. Okay, let's see how we do against Mephisto. Let's do it. So against Mephisto, since we have a lot of hits, we're probably going to enrage this guy super early. So we got to make sure that we dish out as much damage as possible with each rotation by making sure that all of our procs are succinct with the appropriate skills. Alright. Ideally, the next rotation is where I want to finish this first phase. Come on. Finish him. At least finish this phase. Oh, come on, really? Oh, that sucks. Yeah, this is not the greatest. Come on, break him. Okay, there we go. So about 1 minute, not the best, not the best. It's okay. He's not like a rage god. Like, I know I've always said it, but, and it's pretty much common knowledge if you've been playing the game long enough, that rage isn't the best CTP for world boss, but there are a couple characters that make the CTP of rage look like a CTP of energy or a mighty destruction for world boss. Characters like, for example, Venom. You use him with a rage and he just shreds these bosses and you're like, bro, am I using him with a rage? Like, his damage just feels out of this world for a CTP of rage. Shang-Chi is one of those characters as well. Obviously, he doesn't have a tier 4, but like, comparatively to other tier 3s that are strong and use a rage, you can feel it when you use a character like that. I think it's because they have so much chain hit in their kit. Part of the reason why I gave this guy a rage as well is because he also has chain hit, so I wanted to see how he pops with the rage. Because there was also such a thing as diminishing returns when it comes to chain hit damage, right? So, come on, bro, like, really? Yeah, I don't want to do this whole phase here, so I'm just gonna... Really? I'm doing so little damage that I actually have to do the phase. That sucks. I thought my iframe ignore skill would just do enough damage to cook this guy. Nah. Interesting. So a lot of his damage comes from his 4th and 5th, apparently. Or maybe it's because my rage didn't proc. Because there wasn't enough hits. Lots of healing, so I don't have to really worry about dying. Lots of movement on the third skill, but you can kind of see one of the things that I always complain about is the fact that these guys, man, like, look at all the visual noise, bro. Between all of my strikers popping out and doing stuff, bro, and then also sentry skills flooding the map, it's kind of ugly, I'm not gonna lie, bro. And Marvel Future Fight have some they have some amazing graphics, like amazing animation for skills, but like some of this stuff you should be able to turn off. You know what I'm saying? Allow me to turn off the visual attacks from the strikers. There's literally games that have that feature, bro, that make it so you can turn off certain effects that you just makes it look cleaner, bro. You know what I'm saying? But that's just me, bro. Like, simple shit like that I think would make the game more interesting and more fun. I'm saying, sometimes I can't even see some of the cool effects that my characters are using. Okay, come on, bro. But whatever. Whatever. They'll do it in due time. Maybe for the 15th year anniversary, they'll do that. Because that's how these guys operate, right? They'll hear us complain about something for 5-6 years, and then they'll finally do it 15 years later. Anyways. So, level 74... Level 70 sentry. He got it done, but it's not that impressive to me. All right, let me see how this goes, boys. 29. Pretty sure this is the highest that we can go because of the restrictions, but I don't think this is going to be very difficult for him just because they recently butchered Gore. Pun intended. But the way how his skills play out, sometimes it looks like the game is lagging. That's just me. Yeah, like, sometimes it definitely looks like the game is lagging. So I know he's not going to be able to do much against Jean, Kang, and... what's it call it? You can't use him against Black Swan until he's tier 4. So I think after this, I'm just gonna jump into GBR and see how he rocks there, and then I'm gonna just go ahead and power through that level 80. If y'all wanna see the upgrade cost, comment down below. I'll show you the full cost to get him from 70 to tier 4. It's probably gonna be mind-blowingly expensive. But yeah, we gonna do it, because Sentry the boy. Yeah. His fifth skill literally floods the whole map. Well, nah, this guy didn't get the work, so I guess it doesn't flood the whole map. It looks like it floods the whole map, but it actually does not. I think there's only one character that floods the whole map, like fully floods the whole map, and that might be Adam Warlock with his tier 3. That man literally like throws a planet at you. Or is it the moon? I don't know. You'd be throwing rocks. Can't go wrong with saying throwing rocks, because whether it's a moon or a planet, it's a rock. Anyways. Let's see what's popping. The movement speed. Gotta love it. Bro, I literally can't freaking see this guy. Especially when Null starts doing his stuff, bro. Can you see Null? Somebody, bro, find me Null for $5, like, for real. Anyways. Okay, where's my rage proc? Still hasn't proc. Wow. That's wild. Nice, I love that. I love how my proc didn't activate. That shit still... This man is attacking the wrong person too. That's crazy. You know, I just realized, since this is gore, we're not even supposed to be able to use level 70 characters past, I think, 25? So that's good, I guess. All right, let's see how this goes. 2 minutes and 30 seconds. That's what I'm hoping for. Let's see. Okay. Now, can we pop out and wreck this guy? Hold up. Nice. Absolutely spectacular. That's exactly how I wanted that to go. Punch him right in the freaking chest. Gotta be careful with that freaking fire that lingers, because sometimes it hits extra hard and it will like almost one hit your character. Okay. Boom, 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 boom. Sometimes you just gotta pop out and rock out. Okay, come on. No! Let me get the third skill off at least. Yes. So I have, hold up. So he's actually doing way better than I thought. I said 230. Granted, they lowered Dormammu's HP by 20%, but this is really freaking good. Yeah, that's good. Jeez. So it's 130 looking like. Amazing. Yeah, so I gotta say, even though he didn't look too good in World Boss, he actually slapped in Giant Boss Raid. We really need a new Giant Boss Raid, bro, like for real. But this is the build for him right now. It's a pretty stacked build. I don't have his artifact, and we do have just a regular CDP of Rage on him, so keep that in mind. Now, we got the potential done. So we're gonna get him up to level 80 and then tier 4 him. So keep an eye out for the next video. I'm gonna show you guys the full cost to build our very first tier 3 native tier 4. Stay tuned for that.